ご提供いたしますので、オンライン交流会に参加予定の方は、ぜひとも応募してみてください。We are calling for LTs at the online network event today from 6:15. You can apply from the official blog. You can also apply from the link on the chat window. If you plan to attend, please apply.それではこれから鉄尾小山さんの発表を始めます。タイトルは How to plot unstructured mesh file on Jupyter Notebook です。Now we are going to start 鉄尾小山's presentation. The title is How to plot unstructured mesh file on Jupyter Notebook. 発表時間は質疑を含んで15分です。The presentation time is 15 minutes, including questions and answers. 発表前にマイクテストを兼ねて、スピーカーに読み上げ事項を読み上げていただきます。Before the presentation, the speaker will read the paper for a microphone test.
My name is Tetsuo Koyama. The title of my presentation is How to plot unstructured mesh file on Jupyter Notebook.My presentation will be in English. The presentation materials are in English. I will publish the presentation materials. I agree to have my picture taken during my presentation. I will completely with a PyCon JP code of conduct.
ありがとうございます。Thank you very much. 少し時間が、3分ほどございますので、少々お待ちください。Please wait a few minutes.鉄尾小山さん、画面共有をの準備をお願いいたします。鉄尾小山、Please share your screen. それでは、鉄尾小山さん、拍手でお迎えください。Please welcome Mr. 鉄尾小山 with applause.
Hi, my name is Tetsuo Koyama. My presentation title is How to Plot Unstructured Mesh File on Jupyter Notebook. Let me introduce myself first. I am operating under account name tkoyama010. My Twitter and GitHub account are the same. Here is a URL of Twitter. Please follow as you like. I'm interested in scientific computing and visualization with computer graphics. Here is my output. I'm writing a self-published book. The title is Getting Started with GetFEM. This book is a Japanese translation of the Python interface tutorial from GetFEM. It is an open source finite element method library. Here is a URL. I will share this slide, so please purchase it if you like. Next, I will explain what I will talk about today. When visualizing scientific results, we often display the result in 3D computer graphics. The Rabbit is a 3D test model of a famous computer graphic called Stanford Bunny. When I write a book, I use Jupyter to write a book and Sphinx to read it into a PDF. So my big request is to plot this cute rabbit model on a Jupyter notebook. I'm going to talk about how to plot this cute rabbit on a Jupyter notebook. There are two ways to do this today. The first is to plot with a library called PyVista. This library is based on Mesh.io and VTK. This library is under active development in recent years. The other way is to use the Matplotlib3D library. This is an experimental project that uses Matplotlib to draw 3D CG. It also uses Mesh.io and is developed by Matplotlib. Each of them has a QR code, so please access from here if you are interested in it. First, let me explain about VTK used in PyVista. This is a reliable library developed by Kitware that has been used for many years at Los Alamos and Sandia National Laboratories. This notebook is a live VTK visualization using this library, but it has a problem. As you can see, just visualizing it requires so much code like the left side. In addition, we are thinking of turning the Jupyter notebook into a book, so we need to display it in line, and that requires more code. Because this library is originally a C++ library, it has a significant effect on Python API calls. You must do this every time. That's where the PyVista library comes in. There are three symbols of this library. First, VTK for humans, a high-level API to the VTK. Second, mesh data structure and filtering method for spatial data sets. Third, 3D plotting is made simple and built for large complex data geometries. In this presentation, I will talk about the first point. This is a source code which I did the same thing with VTK example. As you can see, we can plot like Matplotlib. After you install PyVista, launch Jupyter, and plot, it looks like this. This is downloading the file example and mesh plotting it. And as you can see, we can plot Bunny in line. This is a very useful tool, but it may require complex configuration for the VTK. VTK must always call X window for window plotting. When publishing a Jupyter on GitHub, it is common to add the MineBinder batch to the README. You need to configure the virtual display in this way to configure the X window. Therefore, when you configure the server, you must set the environment variable and then set XVFV. XVFV is a software that creates a virtual display on services that cannot run X window. So the bash file is complex. So I created a pull request to make it more simple. This pull request defines a new environment variable, which is called the PyVista virtual display, to allow setting of the virtual display. By using this, we can make configuration simple. In this pull request, I added a virtual display argument to base plotter class. I used the library, which is called PyVirtualDisplay. This library wrapping the use of XVFB. As you can see, we can import display object and can start and stop virtual display by method. Base plotter class is a base class of each plotter class, so we can make virtual display for each plotter class. This pull request is under review and will be available when merged. I will discuss PyVista in more details. This library uses a library called Mesh.io for file.io. This library supports reading and writing meshes in variety of file formats. For example, if you import an STL file and want to export an object file, you can convert it automatically by giving each file name extension. Here's a jupyter from Mesh.io. When you import the Stanford Bunny file and view the point in the mesh, this display is exported as an array. The next time you view the cell, this object exports the cell information in list format like this. And that's all for PyVista. Next, I will describe Matplotlib3D. Please note that this project is still experimental and incomplete. This project aims to plot in three-dimensional using Matplotlib. The installation can be done by directly referring to the GitHub repository with a pip command. You can read more about the library in the blog custom 3D engine in Matplotlib. This library uses Matplotlib to achieve the same ease of use that PyVista did by wrapping VTK. The basic idea is to draw a three-dimensional image by projecting three-dimensional mesh onto a two-dimensional surface and drawing projected triangles and squares. Because it is a projection, you are plotting from the back against the project plane. For example, if you plot the lower right box, plot the three face on the left side on the projection plane, then the three face on the right side. This allows you to see how we can plot this by Matplotlib. The library also supports the perspective projection. If you are familiar with the cameras, you may know that the projection on film will look like the top left. With Matplotlib3D, it is possible to switch between the upper left and lower right setting depending on this library setting. And this is a source code of plotting 3D mesh. We can use mesh class and camera class for this. We have to set the camera and connect it to mesh object. We can set to vertices and faces of mesh object. We can read this information from the object file using mesh.io. And this is what we can get in jupyter. Also, it is plotted by Matplotlib. You can use this figure with other contents of Matplotlib. And also, it does not use the X window. You do not have to set a complicated setting. All we need is to pip install NumPy, Matplotlib, and Matplotlib3D. But as I said before, note that we cannot have a full 3D engine because we do not have a proper Z buffer that allows us to test individual pixels. This means we need to sort our points, lines, and triangles in order to draw them from back to front. Most of the time, this does a trick, but there exist some situations where it is possible to avoid problems. For example, consider two triangles that intersect each other. In such a case, we have to decide arbitrarily which triangle will be drawn on top of the other. I recommend that you use this library only for CG learning purposes. Finally, I will explain how to turn the VDK mesh that we have drawn so far into a book. As you know, Sphinx is a tool that makes it easy to create intelligent and beautiful documentation for Python project. Sphinx has an extension called nbsphinx that can be used to document Jupyter. By writing the path to the Jupyter in the Sphinx, you can output the Jupyter result to PDF like this. Now, this is what I want to get. Now, this is a conclusion. We can plot unstructured 3D mesh by using PyVista, and I think this is the best practice now. We can plot unstructured 3D mesh by using Matplotlib 3D for experimental, and I think it is a good challenge to make Matplotlib better. At the end, we can generate book with unstructured 3D mesh by using nbsphinx. And thank you for listening. And I want to say special thanks to Jupyter, PyVista, Matplotlib3D, Mesh.io, and Sphinx authors. Thank you.
発表ありがとうございました。それでは質問の時間を設けます。鉄尾小山さんに質問のある方は、Zoom の機能で挙手をお願いします。Thank you for your presentation. We have a few minutes for a question. If you have any question for Mr. 鉄尾小山, please click the raising hand button in Zoom.いかがでしょうか。少々お待ちください。はい。Just a moment, please. いかがでしょうか。
If there isn't any question, can I do advertisement?
もし内容であれば、私からちょっと簡単な質問で。
はい、Thanks.
I have a general simple question. このテーマを選んだ理由は何でしょうか? Why did you choose this theme?
It's a good question. It is because there aren't any information about 3D plotting because there aren't any major library now because if you want to plot 2D plot in Python,we usually use Matplotlib, but in 3D region, we don't have any major library.
Okay, thank you. ありがとうございました。
はい、
では残り1分となりましたので、そうですね、時間も。残り時間がかなり短くなってきましたので、これで、鉄尾小山さんのトークを終了します。
はい。
The time is up. We will end Mr. 鉄尾小山's talk. Thank you very much for your talk. Everybody, Please give a big round of applause to the speaker. 発表者の方に大きな拍手をお願いします。
Thank you.